In this episode, we travel to the southwest point of Australia and examine the evidence along an undisturbed stretch of coast at Cape Leeuwin. Cape Leeuwin is the windiest place in Western Australia and is battered by winds and storms from both the Southern and Indian Oceans. Any evidence of a tsunami on the Cape itself has long since been washed away. This is, though, a great place to view the granite bedrock that underlies the region. If we are hoping to see obvious tsunami deposition evidence at this location, we might be disappointed at first, but this very lack of obvious deposits is in itself a vital piece of the jigsaw. More of this in future episodes. With waves travelling due east and hitting the coast from the west, we may expect to see some east-west oriented structures in the landscape. There are some subtle features that fit the description. Ideally, I would fly the drone over these features, but this is Western Australia's windiest place. This is actually the first time I've been able to fly a mini drone here despite multiple visits. Flying over these marks though would have meant bringing the drone back directly against the 25 km prevailing wind and with a depleting drone battery. In this case, we can use Google Earth to get a better look. East-west marks are clearly visible, although these are nothing like tsunami chevron deposits. The most important element of this view though is actually the change of vegetation type clearly visible along the ridge. Later in this episode, we examine the importance of this transition evidence from close range. Note for future episodes that coastal heath covers the entire southern aspect of the Leeuwin Ridge from east to west, including the summit at 145 metres above sea level. This southern part of the Leeuwin Ridge shows some possible tsunami deposits, but being directly exposed to wind and storms from both the Southern Ocean and the Indian Ocean, much of the evidence has been eroded over time. To see some more obvious tsunami chevrons and sand deposits, we need to travel a few kilometres along the coast to the northwest. The next stop is near Augusta Golf Course and within the Leeuwin Natural East National Park. The drive takes us through mature karri tree forest, some of which was logged in the 1890s. A few seconds later, and we are now driving through coastal heath vegetation. Here, Hillview Road cuts across the vegetation transition zone at a shallow angle, meaning the change is gradual. At the end of this episode though, we stop in a road that cuts across the transition zone almost at right angles, and the tsunami evidence there is compelling. Hillview Road Lookout has views across Augusta Golf Course to the north, the Indian Ocean to the west, and the high point of Leeuwin Ridge to the south. From the mini drone, the first thing to note are the wind and storm generated sand dunes close to the coast. And then the first look at some tsunami chevron ridge deposits. With a closer look at a chevron ridge. From a higher mini drone altitude, the difference between the wind and storm sand dunes and the tsunami chevron ridge sand dunes is apparent, but this is something that we will be looking much more closely at in future episodes. On Google Maps, the size, shape, and east-west orientation of the chevrons becomes very clear, and is a feature that can be used to determine the direction of the tsunami waves. The tip of the chevron points to the direction of wave travel. In this area of southwest Western Australia, the waves came from the west and moved onto the land due east. From Hillview Road Lookout, we get a great view southeast to the high point of Leeuwin Ridge at 225 metres above sea level. Google Maps shows this peak to have a coastal heath to mature forest transition zone which circles the high point. A future episode examines this important location by drone and on the ground. Our final location in this episode is Green Hill Road, a gravel track that crosses the transition between the coastal heath vegetation to the west and the mature carry forest inland to the east. In this mini drone shot, we are flying over the coastal heath towards the vegetation transition line. Beyond the clearly visible line is the mature forest. Everywhere the natural vegetation remains, this transition line can be followed on Google Maps, north to south, the entire length of the Cape Leeuwin to Cape Natural East region, a distance of around 90 kilometres. This is not a gradual change between vegetation types. This is abrupt and obvious. There is no mixing. On one side are salt-tolerant coastal plants, on the other side are mature trees. As interesting as the drone shots are, the evidence for a mega tsunami wave hitting the southwest of Western Australia sometime in the last few thousand years is actually best seen on the ground. What we see on the ground is likely not what you expect on just looking at the drone shots or viewing Google Maps. This is Green Hill Road. Today I'm in the southwest of Western Australia in the Margaret River Cape region, Cape Leeuwin region, and I'm not far from Augusta, and I'm driving in to get some drone shots at a location. And as I'm driving in, I come across a little bit of a rise, and all of a sudden the vegetation changes. On this side we've got mature carry forest, right, so big trees. We've got a little bit of a rise that I'm standing on right this second, and further towards the coast we have just different sorts of trees, smaller trees on this side as the rise goes up, just larger trees, mature trees on that side. I think I'm standing right on the edge of where the waves came to, right this location. The soil also changes, it's a bit darker on that side, it's a bit sandier on this side. This diagram helps visualize what's on the ground. The carry trees at this location are growing in soil to a height of approximately 30 meters. There is then a sand deposit, approximately 5 meters high, which slopes down towards the forest soil. The salt tolerant coastal bushes and trees are growing in sand on a higher level than the trees. The trees look higher in the mini drone shot, but are beyond the sand slope. This is the line in the sand, the transition zone. This is the point where the mega tsunami sand wave reached its furthest point inland. So I think right this second I'm standing on the at the location where the waves came to at their furthest point inland. So, interesting location. In the next episode, I continue exploring the vegetation transition zone and collect soil and sand samples on a snake and spider infested bushwalk with a bloke who carves statues from tree trunks with a chainsaw. Stay tuned.